Hey everyone, in this video, we're going to be walking through an example solving a problem using the Secant method by hand. As we discussed in the previous video, the Secant method is an open root finding method for nonlinear functions, meaning that we pick two initial x values and then we iteratively solve for a root from that point. I will leave a link in the video description about the theory of Secant method if you're interested. Alright, so we are told to solve for the rightmost root of the function f of x is equal to x squared minus 3 through three iterations of the secant method. So, the function that we are given is just a parabola that is shifted in the negative y direction 3 units. As discussed in our previous secant method theory video, our first step when using the secant method is that we must choose two initial x values. This part is pretty arbitrary as to which values you actually want to choose. However, you can plot your function using Desmos and select two points around your root of interest. So, when we graph our function, it looks like this. I'm just going to arbitrarily select x values of 1 and 3, where 3 is our x0 value and 1 is our previous x iteration. Again, with the secant method, these are just two initial x guesses to get us started. So, let's just quickly draw out our function that we looked at in Desmos here so we can review the secant method briefly. In the previous video, we derived the following formula to find our next iteration of x. So, firstly, to solve this problem, we need to evaluate two initial x guesses, which results in minus 2 and 6, as you can see here. To keep track of our iterations, let's create a simple table here with our number of iterations, the x values, and the evaluated functions at each of those x values. So, let's go ahead and fill in that table now for all the values that we have so far. Now, we are ready to solve for the first iteration using the secant method. Using our general secant method formula, we can just adjust the x values to fit our first iteration. Now that we have the formula written like this, we can simply just fill in the variables as we already have the values from earlier. After doing this, we are left with an x value of 1.5. Let's add that to our table and evaluate the function at this x value. And that is really how simple the secant method can be. Let's just repeat this process two more times to get our required three iterations. Again, let's rewrite our general secant formula for our second iteration. Now, we could just go ahead and fill in all the variables with our known values. And we are left with an x value of 1.666 repeating. Then, for our final iteration, we will do the same thing. Filling in all our variables, we are left with 1.736 as our final answer. Let's just enter our various iteration x values into our Desmos graph. And you can see that with every iteration, we are getting closer to the root. This proves that we are done and that our function is converging through the secant method. In the next few videos, we will examine how to implement the secant method into various softwares, such as Excel, Google Sheets, and Python. If there are any other coding languages you would like me to implement the secant method into, just let me know in the comments down below. I hope this example video helped your understanding of how to use the secant method, and if you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking the join button down below, or our Patreon page to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.